Hey, welcome. So today we're going to tackle a question that's at the absolute heart of economics, really inspired by the thinking of Michael Raviv. Why on earth do prices change? You know, why do things get more expensive or suddenly cheaper? Well, the answer starts when we look at the producer's side of the story, what economists call the supply curve. So let's jump right in. Here's the game plan. First, we'll talk about the market's natural balancing point. Then we'll get right into the supply curve itself. After that, we'll look at the difference between moving along the curve and when the entire curve shifts, and trust me, that's a huge difference. And finally, we'll uncover the three big reasons why those shifts happen. Okay, so before we can really understand why prices move around, we have to know what they're moving from. And that stable starting point in any market has a name. Equilibrium. I mean, think about it. You've seen this happen, right? You go to the grocery store 1 week and tomatoes are a great deal. You go back the next week and bam, the price has shot up. What happened? Well, it's not random. It's the market adjusting to some new reality. And to get that, we need to understand the balance it just moved away from. This right here, this is the market's sweet spot, market equilibrium. It's that perfect moment where the amount of stuff for sale, that's supply, is exactly what people want to buy, that's demand. Now, to really wrap our heads around this, we're going to zoom in on just one half of that equation today, the producer side. It's all about supply.
All right, let's put ourselves in the shoes of the person making the stuff. The farmer, the factory owner, the producer. Their world, their decisions are all captured in one of the most powerful tools in economics, the supply curve.
And this is super intuitive, right? I mean, if you're a farmer and you find out you can sell your tomatoes for a higher price, well, you're going to want to plant more, grow more, and sell more. It just makes sense. Higher prices mean a chance for more profit. And that's exactly why the supply curve pretty much always slopes up. So the simplest thing that can happen with our supply curve is just moving from one spot to another on that exact same line. Let's take a look at how that actually works. See how straightforward this is? The only thing that changed here was the price of the tomatoes themselves. The cost of their seeds, worker salaries, the weather, all of that stayed exactly the same. The price just went up, so the farmers decided to sell more. They're simply moving along a supply curve that was already there.
But what happens when it's not just the price that changes? What if something much bigger changes? Something that affects the fundamental cost of making the product? Well, that's when we don't just move along the line. The entire line itself picks up and moves.
Okay, this slide right here is the absolute key to this entire explainer. A movement is just a simple reaction to the product's price changing. Simple. But a shift is a whole different ballgame. It means the entire relationship between price and how much is for sale has changed because some big outside factor just made it cheaper or more expensive to produce everything.
So what are these powerful outside factors that can literally redraw the entire supply curve? Well, it really boils down to three main culprits.
And here they are, the big three: labor, materials, and technology. You can think of it as people, parts, and process. If you change any one of these, you change the basic cost of making something, and that forces the whole supply curve to move. Let's see how.
So just imagine the cost of fertilizer suddenly goes through the roof. Now it's way more expensive for farmers to grow each and every tomato. So even if the market price is still $8, they just can't afford to produce as much as they used to. Their profits are getting squeezed. So what do? They supply less. The whole curve shifts to the left.
Now let's flip the script. What if some genius invents a new, super efficient harvesting machine? All of a sudden, costs plummet. Now at that same $8 price, farmers can make way more profit on every tomato. So they're willing to supply more. The entire curve shifts over to the right. And that, my friends, is what an increase in supply really looks like.
And this is exactly why a simple graph is so powerful. As Michael Raviv's work helps us see, this isn't just about abstract lines and numbers. It's a tool for thinking. It lets us take a really complicated real-world event, like a new invention or a spike in gas prices, and see exactly how it's going to shake up the market. It really tells the story behind the price tag.
So yeah, let's bring this home. If there's a huge frost in Brazil that wipes out a big chunk of the coffee crop, that's a massive increase in the cost of raw materials for every coffee shop on the planet. The supply curve for coffee shifts hard to the left. And what does that mean for you? Well, it means there's less coffee available at every price, and the price you pay for your morning cup goes up. You are literally feeling a leftward shift in the supply curve.
So today we have totally unlocked the producer's side of the market. We get why they offer more or less of something. But you know what? That's only half the story. To find that true market price, that equilibrium point, we have to understand the buyers. And that brings us to the other massive force in every market, demand.